Are we telling the Iraqis to do imprisonment without trial here at our request?
Well, we most certainly are. The interesting thing is that George Bush set out in saying that he wanted to create a nation like ours, and unfortunately, he may be succeeding. I mean, we have achieved the lowest common denominator in terms of a legal system, and we're trying to get Iraq to do the same thing. Remember, this is exactly what George Bush did. He claimed that he had the right on the enemy combatant program or policy to take an American citizen like Jose Padilla, strip him of his constitutional rights, hold him indefinitely, bar him access to counsel and to courts. And so he's encouraging Iraq to do that themselves. And I think what would be interesting is that Iraq could really emerge as a sovereign nation and not some type of mini-me to George Bush if it simply said no and said, you know what, we're going to go our own way here, not your way. We're going to apply the rule of law. Under that agreement, by the way, it clearly states that the prisoners to be transferred would be transferred either under a warrant or a criminal charge, or they would be released. There's no third option. But, of course, President Bush has been creating that type of new option in our country as well.
There are a whole lot of offshore prisons that the Obama administration is about to inherit.
Well, of course, neither Obama nor Bush need to give a categorical rejection. We already have a constitution that is itself a categorical rejection. And so we don't have to wait to see if Obama is going to recognize what's already in that document. But all of us expect that he will indeed stop these practices. He will close Guantanamo Bay. But the real question, Rachel, is not whether there'll be torture in my administration. No one thinks that Obama is going to engage in torture and continue to torture people. The question is whether he will enforce the law and pursue those who did torture people. You know, if the former president was accused of bank robbery, we wouldn't expect the president, the new president, to say, I'm not going to rob banks anymore. We would expect him to say he's going to go and arrest the bank robber. Now, we have to be frank. There's a credible basis here to argue that President Bush and Vice President Cheney have committed war crimes, and that would make them war criminals. And all of this talk about we have to look to the future and we have to not look to the past, well, in our immediate past may be war crimes, and we sure better look at that.
Well, thinking about the prospect of prosecution, it seems likely that the number two guy at the CIA, Steve Kappas, will be staying on under Leon Panetta if he is confirmed. Steve Kappas, in his role at the CIA, was at least indirectly in charge of the CIA's secret detention policies. If that's going to be part of what is pursued here, doesn't keeping him in that job sort of preclude the realistic prospect that that will be pursued, exposed, and prosecuted if necessary?
That's a very curious thing to do. That's absolutely right. And all this talk about having a truth commission, everything that is coming out of the Congress and the Obama administration is very worrisome. It is not the type of stuff that would be said if you were seriously going to pursue prosecution. But they are insane to try to dodge this issue. Because if we don't investigate this administration for war crimes and illegality, particularly war crimes, someone else might. The fact is the rest of the world sees these as war crimes. How are these people going to travel? What happens when all these Bush officials go off to Paris with their spouses? A lot of the world views them not as tourists, but as war criminals. It'd be much better for us to handle this issue than suffer the indignity of having other nations hold accountable our own leaders.
And us having to suffer the indignity of having knowingly let this stuff go. Jonathan Turley,
correct,
professor of law at George Washington University, thank you so much for your time tonight. It's always
thanks,
such a
Rachel.
Pleasure to have you on the show.
The equally important question of whether his government plans to investigate and prosecute Bush administration officials for their treatment of detainees at places like Abu Ghraib, Guantanamo Bay, and other facilities. In fact, visitors to the Obama website, change.gov, have voted this the number one question they'd like to have answered. The second highest ranking question about the oversight of the banking industry does not even come close. The question posed by Bob Furtick of New York City. Will you appoint a special prosecutor, ideally Patrick Fitzgerald, to independently investigate the gravest crimes of the Bush administration, including torture and warrantless wiretapping? This afternoon on that website, the Obama transition team categorizing that question as one it has, quote, previously answered, posting an answer given by Vice President-elect Biden during a December 21st interview, quote, the questions of whether or not a criminal act has been committed or a very, very bad judgment has been engaged in is something the Justice Department decides. Barack Obama and I are, President-elect Obama and I are, not sitting thinking about the past. We're focusing on the future. I'm not ruling prosecution in and not ruling it out. I just think, the vice president-elect concluded, we should look forward. I think we should be looking forward, not backwards. The vice president-elect's contention that investigating torture is something the Justice Department decides. If you've only been following the Justice Department for the last 8 years and you just assume it's a political branch of the president's party as opposed to an actual independent prosecutorial force, does that sound a little strange? Is it possible that they're leaving it up to the attorney general thinking he'll make the right choice?
Well, it's interesting, if they indeed have made that policy decision in their web answer, it's really going to confront Eric Holder in his confirmation hearing next week with addressing and responding to Congress as to what they're going to do about torture.
There has been, relative to justice, not necessarily with Mr. Holder, but on the blogosphere, there's been a lot of buzz during the week about some of the other appointments at justice. Should we be looking into their identities, their backgrounds, their comments on this thing to determine, to try to guess whether or not, whether it's the attorney general who decides or the president-elect who decides whether or not the Obama administration winds up investigating or prosecuting torture?
Well, we have seen some announcements, indeed, that suggest that people who have no tolerance for this kind of activity. For example, a lot of these problems started with the Office of Legal Counsel. The nominee that Obama has suggested, Don Johnson, to head that office is somebody who has no tolerance for torture, somebody who has indeed been very outspoken about her opposition to the things that have come out of the Office of Legal Counsel. So, indeed, there are some hints coming out as to the direction they're headed.
Tuesday of this week, John Conyers, the Democrat of Michigan, introduced legislation that would set up what he called as a National Commission on Presidential War Powers and Civil Liberties. It would have subpoena power. It would have a $3 million budget. But you have this extraordinary economic circumstance that we're in and the stimulus package to try to sell to whoever is reluctant about it. Healthcare system is obviously a key ingredient. Iraq, Afghanistan, all these things that are of major consequence. Is there likely to be enough political capital for a commission like that to become a reality?
Well, commissions are where you take issues you don't want to confront and bury them, and that has been the long history of commissions. I have the greatest respect for John Conyers, known him since my days at the House Judiciary Committee, and this is sort of a fallback position. I hope we don't go there. I hope there's something much more definitive than a commission.
What do you make, speaking of being definitive, was there a definitive answer contained in the suddenly reposted quote from Vice President-elect Biden about this? Because I would think anybody reading that would suggest that the tone of it is, yes, that is an already answered question, and the answer was, we are looking forward and not backwards, which would suggest no prosecutions.
Well, it could also put this in context, Keith. You have 155 countries, of which the United States is one, that are party to the Convention Against Torture. There's a moral obligation on all those countries to investigate torture when it occurs. This is universal jurisdiction. Torture is considered right up there with genocide. And so if the United States passes on their moral obligation to investigate this, other countries are likely to step in, and this is going to be a huge embarrassment for the Obama administration. So maybe what they're saying is, we are going to toss this to Holder, let him decide what to do with it, and that will defer the issue at least from other countries starting an investigation.
My goodness, what would we do if we had decided not to prosecute this in the Obama administration, and in 2 years' time some international agency made up of many of our allies said, well, you know what, you're going to have this investigation. How would this country necessarily get up on its hind legs and say, no, you can't come and investigate us simply because we don't like that kind of international investigation, or would we have to cooperate to try to continue to restore the country's good image?
I think at that point we'd be forced to do something ourselves. It would be, you know, this is a terrible international incident that's waiting to happen. There are a number of prosecutors who have already made hints in foreign countries that they're going to not let this issue drop. So if the United States does drop it, we're going to be confronted with a real incident.
Goodness.